So after three two-player vintage queues, I've one win, one loss, and one match where my opponent had to go. We're 1-1. But let's face it, I probably would have won that one. This for this fourth match, I'm on the draw. My opponent's taking a mulligan. My hand is not the fastest in the world, but I think it's a good keep. Yeah, I mean, my turn one, I can Gitaxian Probe and ponder at the least. I have a mental misstep, so yeah. Not going to throw this one back. My opponent has kept six and scryed to the top. Dark Ritual could allow me to turn one memory jar. The first thing I'm going to do is probe. Misty, Pyroblast, Brainstorm, Tinker. Yawgmoth's Will. All right. Well, I could go Dark Ritual, Mana Vault, Memory Jar. Or I could just ponder. I think I'm just going to ponder. Could also just play Mana Vault. No, I like Ponder. If I keep that on top. Then I can put Yawgmoth's Bargain into play on turn two and probably win the game from there. Yeah, all right. I'm going to put the probe second. So that I can clear the way and make sure it's not folly to, play my ritual and try to resolve something in the face of a counterspell. Remember that my opponent did scry to the top. So I'm going to probe. I know about Pyroblast, Brainstorm, Misstep, Tinker, Yawgmoth's Will. So if I cast Dark Ritual, it's probably going to get misstep, then miss. I would misstep, and he would pyroblast. Instead, I'm gonna time walk. That eats the pyroblast, which is fine. My misstep and my opponent's misstep are gonna trade almost inevitably, and I would rather do that on my own turn just to get two extra storm counts. Brainstorm, Tinker, Yawgmoth's Will, Mental Misstep. Slightly strange that my opponent didn't cast Brainstorm. So the question here, all right, I'm going to cast Dark Ritual. I'll misstep back. So now I'm going to have 7 mana, floating 1 black. I cast the Bargain. I'm not playing my land first because I could draw into Talarian Academy. Or even if I draw into an Underground Sea or Badlands, it's going to be one more card for me since I'm not paying the 1 life to crack my Polluted Delta. If this resolves, great. I'm very likely to win. If not, I have Time Twister as a backup for next turn. Awesome. So that can help me win eventually. Lion's Eye Diamond. So what I can do here is Mystical Tutor for something, then crack the diamond. Or just not even bother with Mystical Tutor. I could just crack the diamond for, let's say, 3 blue mana. And then keep drawing with Yawgmoth's Will. I think that's a good play to make. Better to do it sooner than later. With Bargain in play, mana is definitely the limiting factor and not cards. Windfall, kind of nice with the Bargain. Wheel of Fortune. Well, I don't have any red mana, so I'm going to keep drawing. In a perfect world, I wouldn't have to cast the draw 7 because I don't want to draw my opponent into counterspell. Now, Tinker, not so good here because I can't get Memory Jar anymore. I could get Black Lotus to break even on mana or fix my colors. That's not very exciting. I'm in Lightning Bolt range here. Go to 2. Go to 1. Now I'll preordain first. See a little deeper. Bottom, looking for tendrils or a tutor. I can't spend life on that. So now I think my move is to brainstorm. Found Ancestral Recall. So I think I want all my mana. Actually, might not need Underground Sea. I'm going to put back Duress and Gitaxian Probe. Now let's fire off some mana sources. I'm going to tinker mostly to shuffle my library, but I can also boost Storm and fix my colors by getting Black Lotus here. Now I'm going to tap my Sapphire and Ancestral Recall. Again, if I can win without casting, without letting my opponent draw more cards, that's all the better for me. And now I found Dark Petition, which should be lethal. Crack for, doesn't matter, black mana. Dark Petition finds Tendrils. And that ought to do it. Sure, I could be a tiny bit safer by, like, Yawgmoth's Will and Duress first, in case my opponent is Stifle or something like that. Flusterstorm? Guess Flusterstorm's a very real possibility. Well, that's embarrassing. Yeah, if I had led with Yawgmoth's Will, that would have gotten Flusterstormed, but I wouldn't have been dead, because then I could just still Dark Petition and... Well, not sure if I would have had enough mana, but if Yawgmoth's Will got countered, yeah, I think I don't know. I mean, I at least could have cast a draw 7, so I definitely jumped the gun here. And Flusterstorm is actually a card that crossed my mind earlier. This can't be countered by Flusterstorm, so it's a card that makes sense for my opponent to have. So what do I need to do here? I just need to make sure that my original copy of Tendrils does not get countered, because then I can win with Yawgmoth's Will. So, complicated stack here. How do I tell what copy is targeting what copy? Oh, and Flusterstorm doesn't even exile, so it doesn't even particularly matter. I guess I can just let them all get countered. Alright, yeah, so it doesn't exile, so this is no big deal. I can just let it get countered, then Yawgmoth's Will and do it again. False alarm. I thought I was in big trouble here. I'm only in... I just made it more difficult than myself. I didn't actually throw away the game. Alright, so now my opponent concedes. Because I was going to use Lion's Eye Diamond and Black Lotus for 6 mana, Duress this time to not repeat my same mistake, and then Tendrils. After sideboarding, just going to use my classic anti-blue sideboard strategy, bringing in these cards, cutting Chain of Vapor. I'm guessing I'm probably against like the Grixis Thieves deck again. Some kind of blue control. Windfall on the draw is bad. Tinker, Jar, Chrome Mox, Cabal Ritual. Sure, I'll bring back the Cabal Ritual. Yep, that'll do. Nice hand. Turn one defense grid. Action left over. My opponent is mulligan to four, so not the best start. When you mulligan to four in Vintage and your play is turn one preordained, you're just going like, why couldn't I this time have Ancestral Recall? Well, top with the preordain, alright. Sure, I'll start with the probe. It's a spot where I would consider fetching first, but I think I am fine drawing a land. So Ritual, Mox, Dark Petition gives me 5 mana. Yawgmoth's Will, Ritual, Petition. Probe, Tendrils. All right, let's just double count that. All right, so first we'll count Storm. Probe, Emerald, Ritual, Dark Petition, Yawgmoth's Will, Probe, Ritual, Dark Petition, Tendrils. So the Storm is good. Does the mana work out? 1, 2. +2 is 4. +2 is 6. Dark Petition leaves me with 4 mana. Then I Yawgmoth's Will, floating 1. Ritual, Petition. Okay, so I'm actually 1 mana short. Did I count that right? Yeah, I have access to 6 mana. Petition gives me 4. Yawgmoth's Will. Ritual. Only 5 mana. Petition. So I can't win with what I have here. What I could do is make that play, and then if I probe into a mana source, I win. And if not, I can just put Necropotence into play. Problem is, I spew off a lot of resources that way. Whereas I could just put Necropotence in play and still have Yawgmoth's Will and all that stuff in my deck. That seems better. Ritual, Dark Petition. Let's take another quick look. Yeah, there's definitely nothing better here than Necropotence, so I'm going to get that. I could even throw a Duress into the mix, which will take away Pyroblast. Then I cast Necropotence. I'm going to Necro for... No need to rush things here. 8 sounds good. Now, discard. I want to keep all my mana sources. I actually didn't find that much. Yawgmoth's Bargain is not good after a Necropotence. So I'll lose a bargain, a defense grid. Maybe actually a bargain and two defense grids. Remember that my opponent did scry to the top, so hand is Misty Rainforest, Dak Fade In, and a card that was scry to the top. But that's I think my opponent decides that the Necropotence is just going to be too much to overcome and concedes in the face of, you know, being down about 15 cards here between a mulligan to 4 and the Necropotence drawing me so much. So, alright, I mean, I played 4 matches, I played against 4 blue decks and ended up, we'll call it 2-1-1, so I think a pretty reasonable showing for Storm. I love this deck in Vintage. If you ever have a chance to play Vintage and sleeve this deck up, I would definitely go for it. You'll have the time of your life. Thanks for watching.